down upon it and to be pleased with what he sees.
That's right.
Good ground keeps itself properly cultivated so that when the seed falls on it, it will also fall into it. Good ground knows the value and the power of the seed being sown. And so good ground is always open and receptive to what God has to say. Because only God has the power to keep the good ground good. That's why the good ground always seeks to glorify God.
Amen.
And the good ground bears fruit sometimes 100%. And then there are other times it's just 60%.
All right.
And at the lowest, it's going to be 30%. Mm-hmm. But when you look at my fruit bearing, I'm always bringing forth something.
Yes.
Somebody is going to always know who Jesus is because they came across my pathway. It's an expression of my thanksgiving unto God.
All right.
It's how I declare unto God how thankful I am. Amen. That it's through these actions of reproduction, mm-hmm, I keep focused on the mission at hand.
All right.
And when God sees that my crown is reproducing, when God sees that I'm bringing forth others like I am, this is when God will get the glory. And my God will be well pleased. And my whole duty in this life is just to make sure that with me, my God is well pleased.
All right.
I've got to stay away from stuff that's going to mess up my good ground.
Yeah.
Because I want my God to be pleased with my ground.
Yeah.
And so in order to keep my good ground good, I've got to be careful of who I let inside my fence. Because there are some folk that'll get inside your fence,
yeah,
and they'll mess your yard up. And so what you got to do is build you a fence and then ask God to hedge up around my fence,
yeah,
so I can keep some stuff out of my yard that's going to take my soil. I've come too far now.
Yeah.
I've got to keep my soil on reproductive ground. To keep my soil fertile so I can bring forth fruit that is pleasing and acceptable to God.
All right.
And so because of that, I don't allow folk who like to lie into my yard. Because God has instructed me in Revelation 21:8 that all liars will have their part in the lake that burneth with fire. If I'm going to keep my good ground good, I've got to keep folk out of my yard that think adultery is cute.
That's right.
Because in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, God said every man ought to have his own wife and every woman ought to have her own husband.
Right.
So you adulterers, stay out of my yard. I've got to keep drunkards out of my yard. Because the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 5 at verse number 18 that I can't be drunk with wine wherein is excess, but he told me to be filled with the Spirit and singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs and making melody in my heart unto the Lord. So drunkards got to stay out my yard. I can't have fornicators in my yard. Because the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 and beginning at verse number 9 that fornicators are not going to enter into the kingdom of heaven. And so if they ain't going to be in heaven, they ain't got no business in my yard.
Yeah.
Amen, somebody. I got to keep the thieves out of my yard. Because the Bible Bible taught us a long time ago in Exodus chapter 20, when God was handing down the Ten Commandments, God said, thou shalt not steal. And then Paul added to it in Ephesians chapter 4 and verse number 28, when they said, let him that stole steal no more, and let him get a job, and let him work with his hands the thing that is good, that he may have to give to them that need it. And so thieves gotta stay out my yard. But not only do I keep thieves out my yard, not only do I keep liars out my yard, not only do I keep adulterers and fornicators out my yard, but I keep old gossiping folk out of my yard. I keep backbiters out of my yard, because I learned in the world that if a dog will bring a bone, that same dog will carry a bone away. But when I got into the body of Christ, I understood that God didn't like backbiters and that God didn't like gossipers. God said, let my yea be yea and let my nay be nay. In other words, provide things honest in the sight of all men. Don't be going around nobody's back spreading stuff that ain't true. And so gossipers got to stay out my yard. I'm trying to keep my yard pure. I'm trying to keep my yard clean. I got me some good fertilizer. I got me some nutrients. And I didn't have to go to Home Depot again. I didn't have to mix just the right amount of zinc oxide. I didn't have to put the right amount of chloride in it. All I did was get me a great big bag of grace and mercy. And I mixed it with a chemical compound of goodness and grace. And then I turned around and I got me some patience. I grabbed a hold of a liter of long suffering. I got me a couple of milliliters of mercy. And I got me a pint of peace. And I put it together so I could keep my ground fertilized. If I don't keep that weed be gone out my yard, then the devil will come in with some stuff that'll make you slide back to where you were. But he can come in my yard if he wants to. I got a solution that's going to make him leave me alone. I got something from God's word that's going to carry me through some rough patches. I got something from God's word that I've mixed up in my chemical laboratory of understanding God's will and God's way that's going to help me keep my ground fertile. I got something in here that the devil can't work without there. And that's the reason why I stay in Bible class, because I need to get everything that I can get so that I can do battle when it's time to do battle. That's the reason I come back on Sunday evening, so I can revitalize my strength and be able to go toe to toe with the enemy when it comes to meet me on Monday morning. I got me some good ground.
Amen.
And I'm determined to keep my ground good. I'm not going to allow anybody, and I'm not going to allow anything to mess up what me and God have straightened up. At one time in my life, I was messed up. I was towed up. I was thrown up. I was thrown down. I was thrown around. I wasn't fit for nothing. And I wasn't fit for nobody.
Amen.
But thanks be unto God, who got something in his word that has the power to change me from what I was up to who I am.
That's right.
It gives me the power to go on anyhow.